Hey friends! Liz here with Full and Fulfilled. Thanks for tuning in today because today's video is about pantry staples that I can't live without, nor do I want. They really are basic things to pull out of the pantry to make meals. The one thing that I'm going to say here is that this is not including rice and possibly wheat and oats and things like that. This is actually staple pantry items that you would buy from the store to have on hand for you to be really, really successful on the go, having a simple meals, being able to pull from the pantry. And so this is just a few that I really, really enjoy and that I always have on hand to make easy, simple meals, because that has been one of my biggest successes, has been keeping it super, super simple. First up is going to be tofu. I don't have tofu a lot, but when I do, I will make sauces out of tofu. I sometimes will eat tofu in some of my meals, but it's not something that I have all the time, but this is a great replacer compared to having cashews, just lower fat content. The amazing McDougall Soups and pasta, ramen, all the things. Here's the thing, these do have high sodium. So what I like to do is make them, but add in a starch. So when you add a starch to it, it is a complete meal and I don't feel so bad about the sodium. And this soup, this split pea soup is so good. Literally, my husband asks for it. I think he thinks that I make it, but it's actually McDougall. And I love this. Once again, I put it over rice or potatoes and add a bunch of vegetables on it. All right, pasta. I mean, who doesn't like a pasta night? So any type of noodle, I like to get wheat of any kind. And then also like a pizza sauce or a marinara sauce. Whatever you prefer, this is a great one that we will make pizzas with, but also sometimes I'll just add it on top of the noodles. I also love the Trader Joe's spaghetti with mushrooms. It literally has fat-free on the front, and this is my go-to for adding it over pasta. But once again, I will sometimes use pizza sauce, literally anything I can find without oil. I love having sushi, so highly recommend my Nori Wraps, these ones I get on Amazon, and they're pretty reasonably priced. Also spring rolls, love making spring rolls, super easy, get these wet, add in a bunch of vegetables of your choice. Super, super easy item to have in your pantry. good old beans, pinto beans, garbanzo beans, any type of beans is amazing for eating starch solution. Just make sure to add in that additional starch, such as rice, potatoes. Beans are so good to put into a soup or a chili, so always have all different types of beans available. I've been loving these lentils. They're in a can, they're already made, super easy. You can add in any kind of spice. You can add them to soups or stews. You can make tacos out of these. So, so amazing to have lentils already cooked. Salsa. I add it on top of plain potatoes. I add it Mexican nights, all things. It's literally added to a salad. It is so good to have this to be able to just add really quick on anything that you are looking to spice up a little bit in your meals. All right, so when it comes to pantry items, you have to look at the ingredients. You have to look at what's in it. You have to look at the fat content. That is so important. And this is why I wanted to do this kind of video today. Pantry items can be super easy and make meals so convenient. You have to watch out. They sneak little things in, oil or high fat contents, weird things that we don't need in our food. And so it is really important that when you buy these items to store in your pantry, that they are real ingredients and that it's literally the best that they can be inside of the can or for your pantry. So I hope this video was super helpful to you. These are just some of my go-to items that are always in my pantry. Of course, there's gonna be others, but these are the ones that I always make sure that are on hand in the pantry stocked. It's really important that I have easy items to be able to pull from my pantry when I'm short on time or I just want something really convenient. Thanks for tuning in to today's video. I hope it was helpful. I would love to know what items you love in your pantry because I keep continuously finding and changing and updating my pantry based on what I do enjoy. So if there's something that you must have, please link it below so that I can try it out because this list constantly changes. So this is in current right now, what's in my pantry that I cannot live without.